Everything so elevated. Everything so elevated. Everything so elevated. Everything so elevated.
What's good? It's your homie AD with GroundSounds.com. I'm chilling here with the homie Jolo. What's good, fam? How you feeling? Was good. So I was actually introduced to you back a couple years back, February 2011, I think to be precise, at the Mad Frog in Cincinnati, Ohio.
Okay.
You put on a hell of a show. They performed. I don't know if you remember it.
Yeah.
But it was killer vibe. The fans were feeling you. I was definitely impressed. And that's actually when I was introduced to the concept of trunk life.
Okay.
And to delve into that further, you in the beginning of About That Life music video,
yeah.
It's actually defined.
Yeah.
Before, for your new fans or the viewers of this interview, can you explain the concept of trunk life to them?
Yeah. Basically, it's like if you look at life as a car, it's obviously
the trunk,
right? You know what I mean? It comes from, you know, breaking into the music industry and doing music that wasn't really me,
okay.
You know what I mean? But just regurgitating what I hear on the radio and what I've seen on the BET. And so I would go to these meetings and everybody would be like, yo, you got it, but you got to find your lane. You
okay.
You got to find your lane. And after hearing that, one day I was just like, you know what? We ain't from the hood, we from the trunk,
right?
And it started out as a joke. Like it was just a, we ain't from the hood, we from the trunk,
right?
And it clicked, and it was like, we from the trunk. That's what it is.
That's what
it's trunk like. And so it's the other side, you know what I'm saying? It's just showcasing the other side of life, not knocking anything else,
right?
But it's just saying, this is where we from, and this is how we do things, and this is how we get down, this is how I was raised, this is how I was brought up. Which is what it is.
You know,
I went to Butler High School here in Vandalia,
right?
Pretty much only black kid in there besides me and five of my other friends, you know what I mean? So
right.
It just really taps into that, and it's like, yo, I gotta be that voice for everybody else that's like that. Because when I went to Butler,
right,
I didn't have anybody to look up to and be like, yo, it's okay to be that dude.
Right.
Or it's okay to be that girl.
You have to be that voice for the people below you.
Exactly.
That's true.
So trunk life, that's what it is. It's me giving everybody else a voice. That's like,
I respect that. To verge on that further, trunk life, it's like a movement. It's like an epidemic. It's not just a phase or a trend. And I've seen several pictures. People got it tatted. And I think the most recent one I seen was in the trunk life episode. Dude got it tatted right here.
Yeah.
How does that make you feel like that you started something that's so impactful on somebody else, like their livelihood, the way that they like what they represent?
It's crazy.
That's crazy.
It's humbling. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's like, this is why I do what I do.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that's why I say I don't do it for me. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing it for everybody that's like me.
That's true.
You know what I mean? And when people get it tatted on them, and actually it's another guy that got it tatted across his chest.
I've seen that too.
You know what I mean? And it's just like, wow. I mean, I have it on me too.
Okay.
You know
so that was my next question.
Yeah,
I'm like, okay, let's see if he has it tagged.
Nah,
okay.
I got it on me.
Okay.
You know what I mean? But it's just crazy when other people go and get it. Like, wow, like that's
right.
For life. That's forever.
Right. That's going to be there.
You know what I mean? That's there. You know, and the guy that got it last, it's his first tattoo. So it's not like it was a filler. You know what I mean? Like,
that's what he started off with.
You feel me?
That's a big tattoo to start off with right there.
Yeah. You know, so he got it. He actually hit me when I was in Cali. Like, yo, hit me on Twitter, like, yo, I'm about to get it tatted. And I was like, wait till I come home, you feel me? And let's film it, make it a vlog. You know what I mean? Like, we just building this Trump Nation, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got a lot of other people now, like, yo, I think I'm about to get it tatted, bro. I think I'm about to get it tatted. I'm like, if it means that much to you, bro,
that's what
you
represent.
Yeah. Yeah.
Support.
You know what I mean? And it's not a hot today, not hot tomorrow type thing. It's forever.
This is something we're doing for life.
It's forever. As long as there's a hood on this earth, there will be a trunk on this earth. And that's forever.
I love that. And I love the message that represents, because like you said, I think there was a time and period when people thought to be rappers, you had to be a gangster, a gangbanger, or a drug slinger. And I think that still exists today.
Yes.
But that's not what it is, and that's not what it was built on.
Uh-huh.
It was built on, you know, having fun and supporting the cause.
Yeah.
And so the fact that you bring that across, I support that message.
Yeah. It's all about having fun with me, man.
Like,
the trunk is where the fun's at. That's the slogan.
There
you
go.
It's about having fun, man. It's about not caring what nobody else thinks.
I'm with
you know what I mean? And just doing you.
Right.
You know what I mean? If you don't come from that, don't act like you
don't represent. Yeah, don't.
You feel me?
Don't falsify.
Don't do that.
I'm with that.
Just be you.
I'm definitely with that. Like you said, you're from Vandalia, suburb of Dayton, 937. Shout out to 937. You went to Butler High School. You're a former aviator. And then in your Trunk Life episode, you went back to one of the football games.
Yeah.
And they've shown you mad love, like the masses just surrounding you. Like, how does that make you feel? Like, you've been removed from school, like, for some odd years. But the younger kids that you never, you know, these kids that you never seeing these kids a day in their life, but they know every word bar for bar in your music, and they support you like that. Like, how does that's gotta be very humbling too?
Very. That's very. That was a big moment. Like, that was big. You know what I'm saying? Like, I went to the game. I came back from Cali, and I was like, well, I was in Cali, and I was like, yo, I tweeted like, I wanted to do Butler Northmont games still be as crazy as they used to be,
right?
And then people was hitting me like, yo, Butler and Northmont don't even play each other no more. I'm like, what?
I wasn't,
you know what I mean?
That.
Like, that was the biggest game for us.
Right.
So I was like, you know what? I want to go to a game when I come home. So I got here. And I went to the first week I got here, I went to the game that Friday.
Right.
I went, and I was just chilling.
Right.
You know what I mean? And, you know, some people was like, oh, you know, coming up saying hi or whatever. And I was standing there with my homeboy, and I was like, yo, it would be crazy if the whole student section was just screaming Trunk Life. And then some friends came, well, not my friends, but they came down there and talked to me, and it was like, yo, you want to come up to the student section?
Right.
I went up there.
With an aviator jersey on.
Right, and it just turned into everybody chanting it, and I was like, bro, I had no idea that all these kids even was hip to me.
Represent me.
Like, I had no idea.
That
blew my mind, you know what I'm saying? It was just like, wow, like, that's crazy to me.
Right.
For me to be able to come back to my high school like that, bro, and get that much love, like, that's what it's about.
Right. That's definitely the thing.
You know what I mean? Like, I was like, whoa.
Right.
You feel me? Like, that was a big moment. So
that's true. That's
very humbling.
Definitely. So, like you said, you spoke on it. You were one of the only black kids in your high school.
Yeah.
You know, except for your core group of friends or whatever. Now, as far as like your core demographic of fans, like, do you find that like it is that you attract more like white fans as far as like high school and college aged as a demographic, or you feel like it's less like urban or black fans?
I think it's a mix.
Okay.
I think it's a mix. Like, you know, and that's what I pride myself on when you come to my shows or my parties. It's half and half. You
right.
know what I mean? And I feel like I'm that middleman
right.
that brings these two worlds together, because it'll be people at my parties, like, they'd be like, what am I doing in here with them? And they'd be in here like, what am I doing in here with them? You know what I'm saying?
They would never go together. They would outside never, of your party.
You
or
feel
your show.
Me? And so it's like bringing them worlds together. It's like, that's why I do what I do. You know what I mean?
Right.
Because, you know, I have family that lives in Trotwood and, you know what I mean, on the other side of town.
Right.
So it's like, but I went to Butler.
Right.
So I have this and I have this.
Two totally different
sides.
You
feel me? And I can work in either area.
And for you to be able to make them coexist is
exactly.
a big thing.
Bring them together.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's what I do. When you come to the parties, it's like, yo, you got this people. And it's people, and they come together, and we have a good ass time. You know what
Definitely.
I mean? And it's dope. So I feel like it's half and half. I mean, I do have a lot of white support. You
right.
know what I mean? I do
right.
have a lot of those.
That's a good thing.
And it is. And I do have a lot of African American supporters too. So I'll say half and half.
Right.
You know what I mean?
That's true.
It's half and half.
There you go.
Yeah.
One thing I wanted to ask you was in your music video, "Best Time of My Fucking Life."
Uh-huh.
You was pouring Henny on your cereal.
Yeah.
Now. That's pretty G.
Yeah.
But I was gonna ask, was that just purposely for the video, or do you do that on a regular sometimes?
Yeah, nah. It was like, I spent last summer in Cali.
Right.
So, Frosted Flakes is my favorite cereal.
Okay.
Like, I don't really
that's
eat.
That's not a bad choice.
Yeah, I don't really eat, you know what I mean, other cereals. So,
right.
I always eat Frosted Flakes, and my drinking choice is Hennessy. So, out there, you know, we drinking Henny every night, eating Frosted Flakes every day.
Right.
So, one day, I'm like, it wasn't no milk left.
Right.
So, I was like, you know what I mean? And I did it. And when I did it, I was like, whoa, I took a picture of it.
Right.
And I put it on Instagram. And I seen people reacting to it. And
right.
I was like, yo, but I really do it. But
right.
you don't put in the video, I put a lot in there.
Okay.
I don't
right.
put that much in there.
Okay.
But you still mix it with the milk, too. So
okay.
you put the milk, and you put a little in
That's
in
the
there.
Combo.
Yeah, and it's good. Some dude just hit me on Twitter today. He's like, yo, I just put Hennessy in my cereal. This shit is disgusting. I'm never listening to you again. I'm like, no, bro. You got to do it the right way. You can't just pour a whole bunch of Hennessy in
right.
there and it be good. Like,
right.
you got to do it the right way.
You got to have the right mixture.
So I think I'm going to do a vlog and really explain.
I think that, would, I think that would be ill.
You know what I mean?
You should try it with different cereals,
yeah.
too. Even though the
yeah.
Frosted Flakes is the main
yeah.
thing, get somebody else hit,
yeah.
too.
You could do, like, Hennessy and Frosted Flakes and Rocky Cheerios, you feel me? Like, Captain Morgan, Captain Crunch, you know what I mean? Like,
he's bringing the whole, okay. I didn't think about it. Okay, that's it.
You feel me? So, you know, you can do whatever you want to do. My choice is Hennessy and Frosted Flakes.
There you go. Not a bad combo. So, not that I know, but I'm going to definitely try it.
Yeah.
Maybe tonight.
Yeah.
You used to be signed to So-So Def, Jermaine Dupri, correct? Are you still with him? Okay, gotcha.
I'm not signed to So-So Def.
Okay, gotcha.
Jermaine is a brother to me.
Right.
Mentor at this point. It's the home.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I learn from him every time I'm around him. You know what I mean? And that's what it is. I mean, I looked up to him. You know what I mean? Forever.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And so when I got with him, it was like, wow, like, dude, I've been looking up to you forever. You know what I'm saying? Like, things didn't work out how we wanted it to with the record that we picked. Like, right. She Say was the record
right.
that we wanted to release as my first single. But it was a sample, Journey.
Gotcha.
Journey didn't want a third sample.
Right.
So things just kind of didn't work out. But me and Jermaine have kept our relationship going. It's strong. It's the homie.
That's what's up. So where did that connection evolve from? How did that stem about, like, getting hooked up with JD?
Twitter.
Okay, wow.
Twitter, but it came through my homeboy, Kenny. Okay. Kenny Hamilton, he's a big factor in Beaver's camp.
Gotcha.
And he sent the link to JD.
Wow.
JD hit me on Twitter and Instagram. He was like, yo, like, let's go. Like,
that's why.
And then, like, a week later, he flew up here, and, you know, he took me around.
So I seen the 1029 interview.
Yeah,
that's wild.
That's wild.
So, being that you used to be like in his camp, his circle, did you ever do any tracks, music with like Bow Wow, the Brad, any of the social deck artists?
Nah, but I was around him. Yeah. I still am around him. You know what I mean? So it's like, but no, we haven't done any of those together.
Okay, gotcha. Are there any artists that you currently want to work with, still on the come up, or already there, or producers for that matter as well?
With me, it's like, I listen to a lot of things other than rap.
Right.
So when I want to collab, like, I want to collab with John Mayer.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I want to collab with Passion Pit. You know what I mean? Like, that type of, I want to do that. You know what I mean? Like, Adele. You know what I mean? Like,
just dope.
Like, rap is cool. You know what I mean? But it's like,
there's so much more.
It's so much more than that. You know what I mean?
Well, and the money might be outside of rap.
Exactly.
I.e. Flo Rida.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Well, that's why he's doing what he's doing.
Very true. What's the, I don't know what the title of the song is, but the video, it's like you in, like, the desert almost. It's not like the desert, but it's like a sandy drop in the back. Like, what's the setting?
That's the best time of my life.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. That one threw me to that same type of setting as far as that crossover.
Yeah.
Oh, that is best time of my life. Okay.
Yeah, that's the best time of my life. We shot that in Vegas.
That's what's up. That's definitely what's up. So you got a new single out, Rod.
Yeah.
The sample is dope in that. The bass knocks. It's definitely something to ride to. Like, like I said, I listened to it two times on my computer, and then I took it to the car.
Yeah.
I'm like, I gotta go somewhere real quick. Just make a run and put this in the car, and it was nice. Windows down, sunroof open, let's go.
Yeah.
That song knocks. What's the plan, like, to execute that, to push that?
We're getting ready to shoot the video for it.
Okay.
Like I said, with me, I throw a lot out there.
Right.
I'm like, let's see what sticks.
Right.
You know what I mean? And Ride is one that's sticking.
Yes.
Ride and High End Fashion.
Okay.
So those are the two records we're getting ready to work. You know
gotcha.
What I mean? We mentioned the Ride video. We mentioned the High End Fashion video.
Gotcha.
Ride is more like the city anthem because I'm talking about the city in there. You know what I mean? And a lot of people
all the suburbs and the boroughs.
Exactly. They can relate.
Right.
Definitely. So we're going to make that. And then High End Fashion is the record we gone. You know what I mean? That's going to be like, everybody can relate to that.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and not to say everybody can't relate to Ride.
Right.
But it's just so, you know what I mean? I'm naming the streets here. Like,
that people out here would know.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like, people in Atlanta not going to know what Salem is.
True.
You know what I mean?
Right,
so,
exactly.
You know, but people like the record, man.
There you
and
go.
It's like, every day they like, yo, Ride. So I'm like, okay, it's what you want. This one don't
get
it. You know what I mean?
Got it.
Yeah.
There you go. So what else is in the plans as far as music projects? I mean, I know you named just the two videos.
Yep.
Like,
and,
you got any tapes or anything you knocking out? Or
we're working on music.
Okay.
We're working on a lot of new music, and that's why I say, like, some of the older music that's old to me,
right,
but not old to everybody else,
they
it's like,
heard
yo,
it.
They haven't heard it. So
right.
It's like, they're like, yo,
we're locked in the chambers.
Yeah, exactly. So about to give them that,
right,
and just push. You know what I mean? Push. So we got, like I said, we got Trunksgiving coming up.
Got you.
November.
Explain what that is for me.
Every year I do a party.
Right.
Day before Thanksgiving.
Right.
We call it Trunksgiving.
Like,
and this is the fourth year.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So we got that coming up day before Thanksgiving.
I will be there.
Yeah. And it's just a party, man. It's a good time.
There you go.
It's a real good time.
That's definitely what's up.
Yeah.
You got a show with Fur coming up, right?
Yep. October 31st in Columbus.
Okay.
Sugar Bear.
Okay.
Sugar Bar.
Gotcha.
One of them.
Yeah.
But it's going to be dope, though.
There you
it's gonna
go.
Be, yo, Just Blaze is on the bills. Who else is on there? A couple homies from Columbus is performing as well. Yeah.
That's what's up. That's what's up. So you got anything else you want to tell the fans, the listeners, the viewers?
iReppTheTrunk.com.
Tell them that again.
iReppTheTrunk.com.
I need one of them teams too.
Yeah, I got you.
That's a bet.
I got you. We getting a Trunk Life shirts pressed up. We actually gonna do like a pop up shop at this year's Trunksgiving. Definitely. We had a merch there. The whole nine. We getting the shirts going and hats, all that. You know what I mean? So iReppTheTrunk.com. That's where they stay tuned with me. Go there. I update. You know what I mean? Follow me every Thursday. We got videos dropping.
Every Thursday, y'all heard that.
Every day. Every Thursday. Trunk Life Thursdays. And so yeah.
That's what's up.
I got my foot back on the gas. We're going.
It's not leaving.
Right.
That's what's up.
On there.
That's what's up. Well, I appreciate you.
I do that.
GroundSounds.com, you already know. AD, Joel the Trunk Boy, GroundSounds.com.